Handwriting is a spiritual designing, even though it appears by means of a material instrument, said Euclid of Alexandria. Recently, I was awestruck by the beauty of handwritten notes in Urdu by my great-grandfather, and I was compelled to think, how far have we come in this rat race of chasing technology? The fear of being considered traditional and backward has made us paranoid. Who could have imagined a few decades ago that handwriting would be on the endangered list in less than a century? In today's globalized world market, where technological innovations have superseded the yesteryear's way of living, the art of handwriting has largely been pushed into oblivion. However, the purity, power, and puissance of ink and paper notes, cards, and letters of appreciation are unmatched in their personal touch and warmth. Let us start this chain of taking out time to go off the grid, look within, and revive this beautiful art. My colleague, Dr. Apra Sharma, and I present before you the handwritten poetry as well as audio recordings of the poems written by our students. I'm grateful to our students and student coordinators, Rashika and Nancy Sharma, for showing keen interest and displaying their passion and creativity. A big hug to all of you, and a special thanks to our worthy principal, ma'am, Dr. Nisha Bhargav. Thank you.
Here is a compilation of 21 gems, a befitting tribute to the challenging times. This activity endeavors to unleash the ingenuity of our students. It brings to fore their immense potential for poetry composition and using paper to unleash their imaginative faculty. They certainly epitomize the values and uphold the ideals that our college stands for. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. Gratitude to the students for being the torchbearers. Heartfelt thanks to my dear colleague, Dr. Sunaina Jain, for making this journey more meaningful. I'm also indebted to our worthy principal, ma'am, Dr. Nisha Bhargav, for leading from the front in these testing times.
Hi, I'm Manjeet Kaur, and the title of my poem is My Best Dream. There's a place where I go, which no one knows, where mysteries are unfolded and hopes grow, where there is just peace in me, where I get to meet the person every day I want to be, under the starry ceiling and in my dreamland. I meet her. She's beautiful, serene. She carries a magical wand. I'm big fan of the elegance she carries in her olive green she wears. She outshines the angels, even the Hera, I swear. And the stars on her shoulders shine so bright. She's epitome of love and courage. She stands so upright. Her maroon beret talks of her boldness. Her beauty is the god's most time-spent work, I guess. She's beyond what poetic words could ever convey. Treasuring the honor of this lady, I just wave her away. Stunned and captivated was my excellency. And the melodious voice on the other side replied me cheerfully. Hi, little girl. I'm so happy to see you. You're exactly my old look. And let me tell you that there will be hard times you will be going through. But I want you to ferry this ocean with your heart and soul. And in the journey, I want you to carry passion in your heart and fire in the belly. Let all your weakness die and strengths rally. You are amazing the way you are. Enigmatic, crazy, a distant but a golden star. A sudden jerk and a daylight beam. Wow, I lived my best dream.
My name is Ayushi Talwar. I am a student of BA second year. The title of my poem is relishing the fire of positivity. In an era of disgust and hatred, a flower that tried to bloom remained unspoken. That sight of immense pleasure unseen seemed like a dream unwoven. That inner peace was hidden somewhere, latent as it appeared to the world. But inside, I knew the fire ignited a different me altogether. And there it came out one day to face the ravishes of the to-be-gone ways. For I stood to change the times. Begone were the days of fright. I started this venture alone. Love, positivity, and growth did bloom a lot. We together then did decide a future full of glimmering sights. That strength came back to us. Latent peace did reflect back. That day, that forgotten flower did speak for love, binding all hopes with untangled ropes. United we stood, with no bars of any religion or caste. We won over negativity. We won over negativity and gave our lives a fresh new start. Finally, gone were the cloudy days of sorrow. Finally, gone were the cloudy days of sorrow. With a blessed face, I looked up to a bright new morrow. Thank you.
नमस्ते, आज मैं अंबिका चंदेल आप सबके समक्ष एक स्वरचित कविता प्रस्तुत करने जा रही हूँ। मेरी कविता का शीर्षक है कोविड-19। बैठे थे सब चुपचाप, खामोश होके सोए थे, अचानक दस्तक हुई और सब एक साथ पहली बार रोए थे। जीवन की भागदौड़ में, एक दूसरे से बेहतर करने की चाह में, सब यूं जुटे थे कि भूल गए थे कि वो क्या खो रहे थे। रिश्ते नाते घर की नींव से परे, सिर्फ पैसा जोड़ने में लगे थे। बीवी बच्चे बूढ़े हो या ज्ञात, सब खुद में खोए थे। आखिर ये बिजी शब्द हर किसी को कितना चुपसा था। मर्सिडीज, बीएमडब्ल्यू, मेबैक की ओढ़ में धरती को प्रदूषण का भरा कारखाना बना दिया था। अरे अपने हित के लिए मनुष्य ने धरती को ही दांव पर लगा दिया था। डेमोक्रेसी, माय विल, माय लाइफ, माय चॉइस का नारा खूब जोरों शोरों से गूंजता था। फिर एक दिन अचानक ठहर सा गया, सब थम सा गया। यूं लगा जैसे धरती, जिसे हम माँ बुलाते थे मगर बिल्कुल अपनी बूढ़ी माँ सा, उसे भी अनदेखा करते थे, उस माँ ने पलटकर जवाब है दे दिया। आई खतरनाक महामारी मानव जाति के बीच और आ कहती, पहले साथ होके भी ना साथ थे, अब चाहो फिर भी ना हो पाओगे। ये बिजी शब्द से चिढ़ गए थे, जाओ अब अकेले तुम रह ना पाओगे। चाहोगे बाहर निकलना, उस प्यारे मददगार चपरासी, अपने खड़ूस बॉस को गले मिलना, मगर तुम हाथ भी ना मिला पाओगे। कोविड-19 का कहर ऐसा बरसा, लोगों ने डर से बाहर निकलना बंद कर दिया। अब जिन्हें सीधे मुंह बुलाते भी ना थे, उनकी याद में उनके फोन या मैसेज करना मुनासिब समझा। सड़कें खाली, गलियां खाली, लगा जैसे खाली हो गई है ये धरती। ना शोर, ना शराबा, ना प्रदूषण, ना कोई क्राइम का है मारा। ऐसा लगा जैसे धरती ने लिया है कदम सब सवारने को, हुआ है इस महामारी का जन्म सब निखारने को। अब सामान्य सा लगता है सब, आज को लाखों कमाने वाला भी कर रहा है घर के काम सब। अब जाके समझ आई हर रिश्ते, हर चीज की कीमत, अब ना होगा हमसे ऐसा गुना, रखेंगे सब कुछ सहेज कर। धन्यवाद।
My name is Diksha and the title of my poem is A Conversation. Look, a shooting star, folding hands with eyes on an unseen par. Then, returning to the discernible, one said, May I find relief. Please grant me this and that wish. The other said, May the world find relief. May the mayhem cease. And when the dialogue was broken, the song of the wind sustained, carrying notes of hope, left unspoken.